seasonal. And speaking of fall, it is just around the corner. And before the kids head back to school and the regular routine resumes, it can be beneficial to start thinking about meal planning. It can help your family eat healthier, also make your time in the kitchen more efficient. Joining us this morning with some great meal planning tips, registered dietitian Andrea Holigner. Thanks for coming in this morning.
Thank you for having me.
Meal planning is something that I've started doing throughout the week because it really does make things a whole lot easier. So let's talk about the benefits. Why should we be meal planning?
Obviously, health is going to be my number one thing. We know people just do better when there's a little bit of planning. Otherwise, things like chopping vegetables and salad just go out the wayside when hungriness sets in, when people come home from work. It's also good for your budget. It's also good for minimizing food waste and generally decreases overall stress in most households.
Which is so key. When you're talking about meal planning, you break it down into three steps to try and make it a little bit easier. Step number one is book it.
Book it. And what I mean about book it is book your grocery shopping day with as much importance as you would going to a friend's birthday party. This is the essence of if this fails, everything else fails.
Okay.
And then we have, you know, random gaps in our grocery shopping list and we're unable to make a good number of foods. So get that like weekly grocery shopping day booked into your schedule with the time that's going to make sense for you.
So before you go, you should have a rough idea of what meals you want to plan for your family that week.
You bet. So when I say step number two is map it. Mm-hmm. And, you know, some people are planners and they will go through this big comprehensive plan on what they're going to do. If you're not a planner, at least have some sense of maybe three meals this week that are going to be on your family's meal planning agenda. And the other days, maybe it's a little more spontaneous. There's some quicker types of food items that you're going to toss in. Maybe there's a little bit of eating out in there. But three meals will allow some leftovers and at least some amount of planning to get you through.
And you've got a perfect example of that here. And kind of doing double duty as well, which is really great. Walk us through what you've brought in this morning.
You bet. So it's Meatless Monday in our house. So we've got an eggplant parmigiana going on here. Mm-hmm. And instead of making one, I made two because it doesn't take you twice as long to make two of these.
Right.
And so I'm going to cook both of them tonight and one of them's going to go into the freezer.
Perfect. So saving you time in the long run.
You bet.
This smells amazing.
There's definitely some good aromas going on here. So
I
prepped this already because Sundays I have a little bit more time to prep as a working mom. And this is a pulled pork. And what's going to happen is on Tuesday, this is going to get turned on. And then we're probably going to have it on buns and maybe a salad. I leave a little bit of the sides up for a bit more spontaneous planning on whatever needs used in the produce drawer of my fridge. And then day two on Wednesday, we'll have the leftovers repurposed into something else. So rather than having the exact same meal, we'll repurpose it into like, let's say like a salad wrap or a tostada, and it'll take on a little bit more of a different theme.
And good variety for the kids as well, so they're not thinking, oh, it's the same old, same old.
Yeah,
your third tip is save it when it comes to meal planning. Walk us through what that entails.
You bet. So any amount of planning you do, save it. And so whether that's coming up with a reusable grocery shopping list, whether that's on an app, I'm a paper person in our house. We have a fantastic grocery shopping list that is always on the fridge, ready to go to add to, and it's really sped up grocery shopping. So if you build it once, there's no point in having to write those things down again.
No question.
Same thing with any of your weekly meal planning. If you come up with a great, you know, two-week supper ideas for your household, save this because on a really busy week, you're going to love that there's a little bit of planning already in place.
And really quick before we go, some convenient food options, and you've got veggies chopped up, ready to go, which make for great snacks on the go.
You bet. So again, if you're going to chop up a few, you might as well chop up a few more. And so cucumbers don't last as long as the cauliflowers and carrots would. So I'll eat these first, and this will come into my work fridge at the office. And as they start to look maybe not so great, then they'll go into a stir fry or something to make sure that we're using those up.
Awesome stuff. Great tips, Andrea. Thanks so much for coming in this morning. And if you'd like more details and more from Andrea, you can head to her website, healthstandnutrition.com.